going to rise up because my time needs me. I'm going to tell you something in the jail. And this is something that was hard for me to understand at first. You know, women, and I just got real mad one day. You know, they were talking about incest, and probably 90%, we'd say 70-80%, probably more like 90%, of our women who are prostitutes and drug addicted were sexually violated as children. It's almost, you know, you can almost tell them their story when they come into you before they open their mouth. And it kills something in them, and they spiral out. And in the end, they end up with AIDS and dying in some horrible way through prostitution and drug addiction and running and stuffing. Those women invariably say, you know, my father did that, but where was my mother? Where was my mother? Why didn't my mother know about it? Why didn't my mother stop? Why did my mother not shut that door? And you know what we do in our churches? And you know what we do in our communities? And you know what we do in our country? If we say, oh, it's just the men, we're the spectators. No, we are the mothers. And it's about time that for the sake of our daughters, we stood up. It's about time for the sake of our sons that we stood up and said no more. We're shutting the door. I don't care who's given me permission. I'm shutting the door. No more pornography in my church. No more pornography in my house. No more pornography in my town. I don't care what you say. I am shunning my life. No more unethical behavior. We don't, you know what we demand? It'll happen, you know. Excuse me. I got an email from Sean that just really upset me so deeply. She probably knew what it was. 53% of Promise Keepers, the men who go to Promise Keepers, were given some kind of an anonymous poll. 53% said they watched pornography last week. 53% said they watched pornography last week. You know, when you look at the corruption in the church right now, I'm teaching a class at Southeastern University on ministerial ethics. And we can hide our head in the sand and say, oh, those Catholics, they are just, all those priests are just so corrupt. No. You know, it's just as bad in all the churches. And yet we have stood by as women and we've said, you know, I don't like driving on I-75, coming in here and seeing all those signs that say, you know, women are just little dolls and toys to their in Hollywood has turned our daughters into little strumpets, little playthings. Pornography has redefined what women are. That they're not even people anymore. They're just little sexual instruments. And we are the mothers of Israel. We are the mothers of America. And if we don't rise up and make a difference, who will? If we don't rise up and say no more, who will? Deborah arose, a mother in Israel. It's time for us to rise up and say no more. It's time for us. It's time for us to say no more. Let me turn to one more passage before I leave here. Isaiah 32. God gave me this passage so many years ago. It says this, verse 9. It says, "Rise up, you women who are at ease, and give ear to my voice. And hear my voice, and give ear to my word, you complacent daughters. Within a year and a few days, you will be troubled, O complacent daughters. For the vintage is ended, and the fruit gathering will not come." It says, be troubled. And it talks about this place of prayer for women to come into. And then if you go down to verse 15, and it says, "Rise up, you women who are at ease, until the Spirit is poured out upon us from on high. And the wilderness becomes a fertile field, and the fertile field is considered a forest. And justice will dwell in the wilderness, and righteousness will abide in the fertile field, and the work of righteousness will be peace. And my people will live in a peaceful habitation." Do you hear what that says? That promise is based upon women rising up. You know, in the Song of Solomon, it says there's a passage that says, "Until she's ready, don't wake her up." It's talking about the bride. Talking about the bride of Christ. And I say this to all of us. It's time that we let the Lord use us completely. It's time. You know, we have just hooked into this learned powerlessness and this apathy and passivity. And we need to take that veil and knock it off. We need to shake the dust off of our lives and say, "I don't know what I can do, but I'm doing something. And I'm just going to trust the Lord that once I step out and do one thing, He'll show me something else. Whatever my hand finds to do, I'm doing it with all my might. I'm going to make a difference. I'm going to stop caring about what people think or who's giving me permission or who's not. Because I'm listening to God here." He says, "Rise up, hear my voice. Stop listening to the voices of the world. Stop listening and listen to God's voice and know that you are a mother in Israel." And it's time for us as mothers, for the sake of our daughters, for the sake of our sons, and for the sake of the kingdom of God, that we make a difference. You know, mothers who drunk driving, the junk drivers would be out there just mowing everybody over. But if your mother said, "You know what? Enough is enough. I'm not taking it anymore. Somebody's got to stand up." And it's time for a mother to rise up and take that place as a mother. Amen? You know, it says, "Rise up until the Spirit is poured out on us." God's waiting for us to take a stand. Did you know that? There's a time, one time, when I was in a meeting. And I was supposed to speak that day. But, you know, people were kind of droning on, and I was just kind of way out there, you know, thinking about somebody. You ever do that? Just daydream? And I was just gone. I wasn't even there. Just staring, and it was time for me to speak. And everybody was looking at me. And I was just passively sitting there. Not even tuned in. And when the speaker finally got my attention, I realized, whoa, all eyes were on me. And there I was, just not even responding. But I think that if we really heard God, we might have that same experience. We might hear God clearing his throat right now, saying, make a difference. Amen? Heavenly Father, I thank you that you have created us for these times, that you have placed us on this earth for such a time as this. Father, that you created us and that we're so much more than we even know that we are. And I ask you in Jesus' name that you might touch our hearts, that you might give us fresh vision. Father, that you, all that you place within us, that you might use those things to cause us to rise up as a mother in America and send the light out into our world, into our community. Father, I ask you in Jesus' mighty name, and if you think that is you, if you say, you know what, I'm ready to rise up, I'm ready to make a difference, I don't know what I'm going to do, but I'm going to do something. I don't know what I'm going to say, but I'm going to open my mouth, I'm going to say something. I don't know where I'm going to go, but I'm going to let God take me to a higher place. I am going to go to a higher place of service, and I'm stepping out in the dark. I don't even know what that means. I want you to raise your hand right now. I want you to stand up. I want you to pray with me. I want you to pray a prayer of dedication. I want you to do that. If that's you, stand up right now. Let's pray together. If that's you, stand up right now. Let's pray together. If that's you, stand up. Let's pray together. Lord Jesus, I thank you that you put me in this earth for a reason. And I ask you, Lord Jesus, that you might reveal to me what that reason is. I thank you, Lord Jesus. I will take my place as a mother in America, and I will do what you ask me to do, Lord. I'll say what you ask me to say. I'll be who you ask me to be, Lord Jesus. Father, I ask you in Jesus' name that you anoint each one of us, that we might go forth and shine our lights and make a difference. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. God bless you.
Scripture, different things like that. So we do have those available. Mm-hmm.